know I'd go back.
Welcome back to my channel. Hey, welcome back to my channel. Hey, welcome back. Hi fam, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Rizzi Ruthie. Thank you so much for clicking to watch my video. If you're new here, thank you so much for clicking to subscribe to my channel. To all my new subscribers, I love you very much. To my old subscribers, thank you for sticking by me. And I saw that we finally hit 4,500 subscribers. Thank you so much. So the journey to 5,000 begins. Just tell your friends and their friends and their friends and their friends and their friends to come and subscribe to my channel. All right, so today I'm giving you a two-part tutorial. It's going to be, of course, on the eye look, how I achieved this glitter cut crease look, and also my skin work is going to be the part two of the tutorial. If you have very oily skin, large pores, textured skin, and you live in a hot area, or it's just the hot season where you live, this tutorial is for you. So the part two is going to be just me explaining how I keep my foundation lasting all day under hot weather and having very oily skin as well, that is prone to basically cracking and all that. So that's the part two of this tutorial, and I'm pretty sure that you're going to find it very helpful. So just go ahead and give this video a big fat thumbs up, because I know you're going to like it. You must like it. Okay, so just give me a big fat thumbs up, and of course share the video as well so that people can find it. Share on Facebook, share on Twitter, share on Instagram. Thank you very much. Namaste. I love you, I love you, I love you. All right, so I don't want to talk too much. Let's just get into this video. I'm going to be starting, of course, part one with the eye look, and then part two with the skin work. I'm going to be linking the two videos here just so that you get to find both of them. I love you very much, and I'll catch you in the next one. Yeah, today we're going to be doing, you know, a tutorial on how to keep your foundation flawless all through the day. I always start by using the Pond's Lasting Oil Control Vanishing Cream for very oily skin. That's the one with the pink cover right here. So the secret to this is applying little quantities, and then make sure that you blend immediately you apply, so you're not just, you know how normally there are other primers that you can apply and just all over your face and then come back and blend. You can't do that with this Pond. If you do it, you're going to end up with some white cast all over your face. So you're just basically applying it evenly all over your skin. I find that the brush actually gives a very even cover, and it helps me blend better than my fingers. So if you have issues blending this oil, this Pond's cream, then use a brush. Drying up and mattifying up like this, then you know that the Pond's oil control cream is already, you know, set. So what I'm going to do next, as you can see, I don't have those white lines all over my face. I know I look whiter than normal or ashier than normal, but I mean, I don't look crazy. So what I'm going to do next, which is step number two, is to set all over my oily areas by using a setting powder. And the setting powder I'm going to be using is the Sasha Buttercup. I just basically put my powder brush in it like this, and actually, to be honest with you, I get oily everywhere, so I'm just going to basically set everywhere. So for those people that get oily around their T-zone area, you guys are so lucky. You guys can just basically set your T-zone area, but for me, geez, even my eyebrows can get oily sometimes. So I'm basically just going to set everywhere with powder. I'm not brushing, as you can see. I'm basically like pushing it in. That's just the way to help yourself. So this is basically step number two. So step number three is basically for you to use an oil-free foundation. Especially if you're very oily and the weather is very hot. Two things that don't mix together. So basically, run away from all the oily foundations during the hot season. I'm not saying that someone who has oily skin cannot use oil-based foundation. Things like the True Color by Black Opal, you can use them, but maybe you can get away with using them during the nighttime when the sun is not so hot that it basically melts, you know, the foundation on your skin. So you go for oil-based and matte foundation. So what I'm going to be using now is the Zaron Healthy Glow Foundation. It's in the shade FZ40, and it has oil control in this. This is completely matte. So I'm going to be mixing that with the LA Girl Pro Coverage High Definition Foundation in the shade Rich Cocoa. The reason why I'm mixing these two is this one has more of a red base, this one has more of a yellow base, and I'm somewhere in the middle. So if I mix the both of them, basically just need to use like two pumps of this one. If I use mix the both of them, I find that I get better coverage that way. I'm not going to be too yellow and I'm not going to be too red. So I'm just basically using like two pumps of the both of them. I don't know if that's going to be too much. If it's too much, I'm not going to use it. Now, one thing I also learned to do in recent time is to avoid too much foundation. If you have very oily skin and it's the hot season, you're going out and you're going to stay out for a long time, avoid too much foundation. Like, you will thank me for doing this. Reduce the foundation you put on your skin. If you do that, you tend to get less oily. So this is just basically one push of my brush in the foundation, and this is what it's covering. It's basically covering like half of my face, and if I don't finish the foundation, I'll just do away with the rest of them. So I'm just using my Barriad Cosmetic. It's supposed to be a contour brush, but it applies foundation so evenly. I started using it for foundation purposes, so nice. So this is the second pump. This is the second push of my brush. And one thing I like about this brush is it doesn't swallow your product. So anyway, another thing I've noticed is when I want to put foundation all over my nose, I do it with a pushing motion. I don't swipe at all, because when I swipe, I find out that probably like an hour or two under the sun, and the foundation around my nose will start to crease and it will start to melt off, no matter how much I set with powder. So for my nose area, which is very, very textured, I just go in with like push motions. And that's how I put my foundation there. And I try as much as possible to put very little foundation around that area. And thank God I finished all the products, because I had to blend into my neck as well. Alright, so for my concealer, I'm going to step number four as well, is to use an oil-free concealer and use more of a water-based concealer and a mattifying concealer. So for that purpose, I'll be using the Zaron liquid concealer, and I'm going to be applying minimal quantity as well. Like during the hot season, the days of you basically just putting concealer all over your face is just over. Keeping in line with what I said before, that you have to make sure that you use, you know, less product than you normally would go for during the hot season. That's the only reason why. I'm just spreading this one evenly. It's not like I'm applying any more product. I'm basically just spreading. And around my nose, because I want to make my nose look smaller, I'm just basically going to apply some concealer on the edges of my nose. That would help to blend things out properly. Alright, so I'm just going to go ahead and blend using my booty blender. It's already damp. It's going to be damp, not wet. I'm going to squeeze it and you can't see any water. That's what it means, that it's damp, but it's not like soaking wet. So I'm just going to basically go in and blend. It smells like perfume. You see, that was basically all the foundation. That was all the concealer that I needed. I didn't even need it too much. All of my kisses down low makes me arch my. So I am completely blended in and I'm looking a little bit gray, but it's okay. Now step number five is to go ahead and just, you know, set all the areas where you used your concealer. And for me, I don't like to bake. This is very optional. You can bake if you want, and you don't have to bake if you don't like. I don't like baking because I realized that when I don't bake, I have more of a natural finish than when I bake. So I just basically go in with a flat foundation brush and just apply that same Sasha Buttercup setting powder to all the areas where I applied the concealer. Ding, ding, ding. Head and contour my face using a powder contour. I don't know, it's just personal preference that I like to use powder contour for my face. If you like to use a you know, liquid contour for your face, then you can go ahead and go and do, you know, the liquid, but also just make sure that it is oil-free product that you're using for, you know, those areas. So step number six is to make sure that you set the rest of your face using your face powder. And I'm just basically I put my powder brush in my powder palette, the one by Barrier Cosmetics. I'm basically just powdering the whole of my face. As you can see, I'm using a sweep, I'm using a pushing motion, not a swiping motion. This would help to really, really, like, you know, set the rest of my face. Now for the areas where I, you know, use the setting powder, I'm just going to take the powder in my shade and I will just brush off any excess like this. And then go on to set as well. Is to basically lock it in and remove all the powdery effect on your face because of all the setting powder and your powder. So you're going to lock in your makeup by using a setting spray. Now you can actually go for, you know, a mattifying setting spray, but this one that I'm using today is Zarin Perfect Finish. It is not a mattifying setting spray, it's just a finishing spray. So what this would do for me is it would remove the excess powder on my face. So for that reason, the fact that this is not a mattifying setting spray is going to make me use less of this product. So I'm just going to spray sparingly. And really, this is the end of the whole tutorial when it comes to the skin. I'm just going to go ahead and highlight my face. I'm going to do my lips and I'll come and show you the finished product.